This episode is being recorded out of Shop Talk Podcast Studios in Oak Park, Michigan. For more information, visit www.shoptalkpod.com.
It's just a D girl from around the way with a whole lot of shit to say. It's your girl, KD.
What up, though? It's your boy, DTM, a.k.a. B-I-G-T-A-Y, a.k.a. Pure Motivation, a.k.a. I am Mr. Energy. Everybody loves me. I don't think I had not one enemy. If you know me, then you know I'm more than a savage. Man, I love living life, and I'm allergic to average. It's your boy, DTM, Deontay the Motivator. What's good?
What's good?
Hey, hey.
Appreciation to our boy, Jay Johnson, for that motivation to have my husband write that whole
rhyme. Feel me?
Shop Talk Podcast.
Man, if I almost got back in the
If
booth.
You ain't with it, you better get with it. Get with it, Productions.
I'm trying to tell you.
We got a surprise guest today. We didn't plan on having this guest, but she was like, hey, what y'all doing? We was like, hey, recording. So what's your name, special guest?
Special guest. I'm not a guest anymore, but...
Holla.
Hey, it's KiKI.
She is officially our third host, y'all. What's good? When you making moves... on the air. She's our official third guest, y'all.
So happy to be here.
So you will hear from her more often than not. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, little reality relationship from all... from all aspects. So, yeah, she has officially accepted the invitation to be the third guest. I mean, the third host. Hostess.
With the mostest.
Hostess with the mostest. It's your girl, KiKI.
Hey!
All right, y'all. So we're going to get this crack-a-lacking, you know. What are we starting off with, DTM?
So this week, man, you know we normally start off with one thing, but we're going to switch it up a little bit this week, and we're going to start off with another segment that you guys heard and love, and it's called... That's what we on right now, man. We about to do this Wild Thoughts, man. So for those of you who may have just, it may be your first podcast for whatever reason, you've been living under a rock.
Definitely.
I'm glad that you are definitely from under a rock. Because this is the number one podcast right now. Listen. Wild Thoughts is we throw out a word and it got a hole right there, baby. You got to pull it through the hole. We throw out a word and you say the first thing you can think of. Man, listen, I'm about to make an executive decision.
This is gonna be a
to start recording because y'all need to see exactly what's going on in this junk. Because this is. All right, so So Wild Thoughts, man. We about to get it in with Wild Thoughts. Let's see. We're going to do 5 and 5. So which one? Who's going to start it off?
KiKI, going first.
You know, I don't care.
All right. So KiKI got the first 5. Mm-hmm. KD going to jump in and do her.
And then DTM doing 10.
Well, KiKI got the first 5. She want me to do 10. And then KD going to finish it off with another 5. All right.
Are we going to go girl, boy, girl?
Yeah.
Okay.
All right. So, you ready, KiKI?
Yes.
All right. So,
always.
I'm going to throw the word out there. You give me something right
now. No
back.
Sounds, first, only words.
It's hard not to do sounds.
Only words, BFF.
I'm
going
to try.
Don't hesitate.
We're gonna
don't try. Think about it. Just give it that wild thought.
We're going to try it. She's only one person.
I mean, so I feel like 2 right now, but go ahead.
All right, ready?
She's drinking that reality juice, y'all. Holla at your girl for all your mixology needs.
All right, let's start. Mm-hmm. Click.
Huh?
Dig.
Deep.
Throat.
Game.
I can't hear it. Wait, what was it?
Game.
Throne.
Lick.
Stick.
Water.
Wet.
Chill. That's it.
Wow.
That's it.
Yes.
All right. You ready, DTM? Because you got 10.
I got 10. Dang.
It should be interesting.
Y'all ready? It should be super interesting.
I'm so excited because me and DTM
Just me and DTM
had a conversation last night that sparked these these words. So y'all know me and DTM been together for like 20 years. Uh-oh. So we're like kicking it about shit that happened back in the 90s.
There we go.
I was drunk. I don't remember none of that.
No, he might have been because I was experimenting with some drinks last night. So he might have been.
Ready? I don't even drink. Let's go.
All right, is you ready or no?
Let's go.
Wait, my phone locked.
Hold All right, don't let it lock on you now.
I don't even know the code. All right, y'all ready? I mean, you ready?
Yeah, we ready.
We ready.
Couch.
You.
Car.
Sex.
Chicken.
Dinner.
Swing.
Yes. Feed park. Me, Seymour.
Park.
Sex.
Wife.
Sex.
Kids?
No sex.
Come?
Now.
Blue.
Oh, yes. Now.
Uh-huh. Cherry.
Pop.
Ha! He did sounds.
What'd you say when you said couch?
You.
We're going to tell y'all about that a little later.
y'all remember that. Couch.
Remember
you.
Couch and you. Couch for the, you. For the segment.
I'm not sitting on the couch anymore.
No, this couch been gone.
Yeah.
This couch been gone.
This was one of the old boy. Yeah.
This is a couch back in the 90s.
Oh. All right, Katie, you ready?
Huh? Who what?
For your
five. Oh, my wild thoughts.
Yeah. Your five.
Okay, I'm ready.
You always do it so good. Don't do that.
I'm ready.
All right. All right. Gooch.
Lick.
Lick.
Gooch.
Ice.
Yes.
KFC.
Fuck.
Smile.
Yours.
Pussy.
Yours.
You.
Yours.
That's it. I've been winging it, but I just want you to keep saying yours. I'm like, yeah.
Wait, let's start over. Let's start over. Let's start over.
How she feel today.
Let's do it one more time. One more time. One more time.
One more time.
That's a little intense in here.
Reality Jew.
I am the bomb. Okay, I'm done.
She is on 10 today, y'all.
Right.
Sorry.
When I'm with you, all I get is wild thoughts. And that's wild thoughts for you guys, man. I hope you guys like that one.
It was so much fun. You should have been here.
You should have been here.
Definitely.
All right, so.
It's hot and steamy.
It is hot. Why?
No, I'm not talking about that hot. It's hot.
I'm about to say,
on the ones and twos.
That reality juice might be getting you.
Holla at your girl for all your reality juice needs.
Man, it's going on. Y'all going to see. I'm going to do a little commercial or something.
I'm so, excited.
So we can get it in. It's about to be.
It's the bomb, though.
It is.
It's definitely the bomb. I'm excited.
Your girl is a mixologist,
It's the bomb for me because I love watching you like be so excited about doing this stuff. You know what I'm saying?
I'd be so excited. I'd be like, oh, my God, everybody come taste this.
Come taste, right. I get texts all day from work like, yeah, I'm going into the lab. I'm like, I remember telling you the same thing. Like, I'm going into the lab.
Like I was in the lab today fooling, though, y'all. Like, fooling. That's probably why I'm a little inebriated. And BFF because I had pulled her in the lab. I was like, what you doing? Nothing? Come to the lab.
Yeah.
And she was like, okay. She ain't even know.
Yeah.
She didn't even know.
She had no idea what she was walking into.
The neighbors. I don't have the neighbors in the lab.
Right. They tell you standing on the porch. Somebody, can I have some more?
Right. That's how good it was.
They're not allowed
we was
to
leaving.
In,
they're like, can you make one more?
Yelling through the window. Beast. I'm like, what is going on?
I'm a beast at this mixing thing.
And I was supposed to be at my brother's house taking him to KFC. I was like, you called. I was like, you know what? I got to go.
He probably wanted to come.
I said she going to the lab. Like
he probably could have came to the lab too. No, he can't come to the lab. He can't come to the lab because he got to take care of himself.
Right.
Okay.
Draw the line.
Yep. Hey, you know what it is. All right. Let's jump into the next segment, man. The next segment is the lightning round.
Mm-mm. What's right? that?
The lightning round is when it's like this or that. So I'm gonna throw some stuff out.
Oh, you like this one?
I like this one.
She's smiling, y'all? Okay.
I'm going to throw some stuff out. You got to tell me which one.
So who going first?
Let's see. KiKI going to go first.
Oh, you going to go first?
I always go first.
You do always go first.
I don't care.
All right. So Let's see. I don't have a whole bunch of them though today. So we're gonna go.
I mean,
so what if I just throw it out there and both y'all answer?
Ooh. Mm-hmm. Okay.
All right, but
we winging it?
All right, so the first one for the lightning round. Shopping or traveling?
Traveling.
Oh, I like that. Getting oil or doggy style?
Doggy style.
All right, jacuzzi sex or balcony sex?
Jacuzzi.
Balcony. Oh,
yeah. Balcony.
The balcony versus the jacuzzi.
It's something about somebody might see you that's just exciting. It's exciting.
So this next one, y'all got to know who you asking this question to.
I
thought about this one. I was like, yep, this is going to be a hard one. She been answering these other questions kind of quick. So let's see how she answer this one here.
Uh-oh.
A great dinner date and mediocre sex, or great sex and mediocre food?
Great sex. That ain't no question.
First of all,
it wasn't a question for
nigga,
you.
Nigga, you could dig me down and take me to McDonald's.
First of all, you
I
know,
knew
I,
it wasn't a question for
first
you.
First of all, I have to but eat this before one, I eat.
See what I'm
first
saying?
First of all, she already ate before she came to the date.
So I'm already good, you know?
That's why.
She already came. Sex.
That's why I thought that was going to be hard, because I know you and your food, you like.
But you know I eat before I eat. So I done already ate before the dinner date. I don't even eat.
Anyway.
Yeah.
So dig me down.
Yeah.
And give me a McChicken.
Yeah.
Don't give me no motherfucking Osaki with no motherfucking whack ass dick. I'm straight.
Definitely.
Y'all hear the K on that word though. Dick.
I'm just saying, don't motherfucking give me blue click.
That wasn't a hard one at all.
Now you gonna give me blue click with a motherfucking filet mignon.
It wasn't.
I got one more. Yeah. I got one more for y'all. Accidentally send your parents a sex video or accidentally receive one from your parent?
Oh,
I
got to
send
shit.
It. I got to send it. Because I don't want to see yours.
I'm going to send it. Because you know what?
Yeah.
You seen my pussy before. I ain't never seen your pussy.
Exactly.
You should have. You came out of it.
I was blind.
Plus, theirs don't look the same. Like,
and
still
my
pretty?
Parents saw me had kids.
Yeah.
I ain't never saw my parents had
kids.
They
probably got saggy everything.
You know what I'm saying? No, I won't see no wrinkled ass pussy.
Do y'all think pussy sag?
Mine's still pretty.
My pussy's still pretty. I'm saying my pictures all the time. Like, kill them.
I do think it changed. Like, when you get older, like, the breast sag and everything sag. So, why wouldn't, like, the clit, like,
different? Why wouldn't the pussy get wrinkly?
I definitely don't want to see that though.
Not at all.
But I show everything to my parents anyway. I was just showing my mom, you know, my ass earlier. Like, do you want to see my panties? She like, no. I'm like, look.
She like, I'm fat ass.
Yeah. That's
first
what she
of all,
said.
My mama just whole like, ass molested me on a friend's porch. Right. In front of the neighbors, like, I always grab her ass. I'm like, ma.
Right.
So now the neighbor's gonna be trying to do it.
It was the ladies.
I know.
Dang, I ain't trying to fuck neither one of them.
First of all, we don't even know them. We don't even know them.
First of all, KiKI walked on the porch like, who is them?
I don't know.
I'm like, oh my God, this is my mama's friends.
But I'm like, do she like them?
Well, out loud though. Like, do she like them?
You know, she's Caucasian too. So she got to find one or two.
First of all, chill on my mama. I'm just saying,
she got to pull one or two. You know what I'm saying? To help out.
Chill on my mama, my nigga.
They seem nice, but...
They was cool.
But, yeah.
They go through a lot with their children.
Okay, but...
Then we don't go through with our children.
I know. My man, I don't even see my man that often, though.
Bro, speaking of which, I don't know this podcast talking about, but I'm going to talk about it. My man be disrespecting his mom, right? Mm-mm. My mama like, I'm going to tell my son on you, and he's going to get you together. So she
be putting me out there on air.
So she
man.
Just really made you a whole ass project.
Mm-hmm.
Bro, do be disrespecting his mama though. But I had told him like,
who the son?
Yeah, the older one that be out there with the dog.
Oh yeah, my man told me to holler at his son.
My mama's like, I'm gonna have my son talk to you because he's a motivational speaker. He's gonna get you together.
I was like,
I'm just trying to see what we doing today though.
She tried to put the son on me. She tried to put the lady on me. She tried to. She was like, listen, they
because
all
she think I'm you like, got the magical.
I'm like, I'm just
take out the magic stick.
Yikes! All right,
he do though.
All right,
he get me together.
Hey,
I don't know about nobody else.
That's just me focus. You know what I mean? Just focus. And it's weird that you said that because that kind of dips into the show portion of the day.
I'm sure that's gonna lead to the next segment.
so We're gonna get into a little content today, man. We want to feed these people.
This is my favorite part.
You know, we're gonna feed. I think
everything is my favorite part. I say everything.
I was about to say you was like everything is your favorite part.
I just love this whole podcast. Like you do not understand how I be so into it at work. Like Wednesdays, I'm like, damn.
Do you re-listen to the ones that you've been on?
I do. I listen to all of them again.
I listen to all of them again.
She said, "I'm on all of them. I listen to all of them. I'm on all of them."
Because I am all of them.
So, the first question I got for y'all is something that I think a lot of people might have an issue with.
What? They got an issue with?
Let's talk about it.
And it's called, people talk about it often, but they don't really go into details, but it's the whole work-life balance.
Oh, we might not want to talk about that today.
So how do you do it? Like, how do you make it work? How do you figure it out? Some people might not know. Sometimes it may work out good. Sometimes it might overload on one side and not the other. But how do you make sure that it's balanced? The work life is balanced.
You gotta make time.
For what?
For the relationship. Everybody gotta work. Are you talking about like the working and
yeah? Like how do you
like
know
the relationship?
Yeah. So like for me, I try to watch.
Can you turn your phone on silent, please?
I'm trying to go live.
So for me, I try to watch to see, look at the signs. I try to read the signs to make sure that, you know, I can tell when she's getting irritated or she feel like she
can't tell when
time.
I'm irritated because I'm irritated right now. He worked like 15 hours today.
But she says it. So, I mean, it's right. It's like we say it, though. It's sometimes, like you can't even. It's
sometimes
like you don't
she
even
said,
have
but to, your body said before the voice said.
That's true.
You know what I'm saying? So it's up to the man to pay attention and the woman because it can go both ways. Mm-hmm. But it's up to them to pay attention to the actual body languages while she up here making love to the lie. But
making love.
Oh, look, MJ, he wearing your thing. Broken Rebel. Shout out to Broken Rebel.
I like that. I want a shirt. MJ.
That's MJ.
I want a shirt. You're not even getting me. Like, it's
like
my arm.
I don't know what the fuck I'm doing. All right, let's cancel out of here.
But yeah, so, you know, how do y'all, any suggestions, any tangible suggestions for the people to know how to balance that work life, you know?
Not even just the work life. I think it's like the kid life, too. Like, if you have kids with different...
So I mean, but that's
relationships. Like, say, I have kids with someone, but then my spouse has kids with someone else as well, or different. We have to make time because you know they have sports. My kids have sports. We have work. Like, you have to just manage your time. It's I don't know. I have the same question too. It's hard.
And that's what it is.
But
I think
you have to make it work. Like you have to make it work.
I agree, and I think it's. The work-life balance is telling you that work is not your life, but then you got your life on the outside, which is, in a nutshell, the kids, the spouse, you having fun, too, just to make sure that you're not just work, and going insane.
I feel like you have to set up a schedule sometimes, though. Not just for sex, but just for, like, date time. You know what I mean?
Yeah, you definitely
You got to have, like, a date night. Where you could just put aside, like, the kids don't have games, they don't have this, they don't have that. You know, just have a date night so that you could just, I mean, be with each other. Because other than that, it's hard. It's hard. Everybody works. Everybody, kids play sports. And it's like, you just got to manage that time. You got to put aside a day. Like, nobody has sports on Sunday. So, okay, we got some time. Let's go somewhere Sunday. You got to make that time. Because if you don't, then it starts to fall apart. Right? And then, now she's complaining. It's not really the male that complains. It's usually the female that complains, right?
Like, we complain. It can be both ways, though.
It can especially, be, but most of the time, it's the women that has the complaints about we're not spending enough time together, you're working too much, or, you know, blah, blah, blah. But it can be opposite. But most of the time, I think it's the females that complain the most.
But I think the females might complain that you're working too much.
Yeah.
But I think the male's complaint might be somewhere along the lines of, you hanging out with so-and-so too much, and you're not giving me enough time.
That's
you know
true.
What I'm saying?
That's true.
So I think even all that, the bodies tell the sign first, and then the mouth, once the body get tired, then the mouth says something too.
I think I'm different though. Like my mouth gonna say something first. I'm irritated. I am. Like I already show when I'm irritated, but my mouth is like reckless. So
yes,
I'm
is.
Definitely going to tell you like when something is not right. Like I'm not gonna just. I mean, you gonna see the body language too. But I think I'm like too outspoken sometimes. Like especially in a relationship, and that it kind of is bad. I think because now they feel like I'm saying it in the wrong way, which I guess I could say better sometimes. But so it'd be like, you be at the point where it's like, I mean, you're frustrated at this point. So it's like,
which means your body was saying it before.
I was saying it before.
I mean, my mouth was saying it before.
My mouth was saying it. And then now you get the body language and now I'm acting funny because I've already told you 3 times that we're not spending enough time together. Right?
Yeah.
So and now, I mean, now you're going to see the attitude. Like, now I'm going to have the I don't give a fuck attitude because now I've already told you 3 times and you're like, okay, but nothing has changed.
And see, that's what I look at. That's what I really pay attention to because my current job during the holidays, it's like slave season.
Mm-hmm.
But I still make sure that, you know, when I do, like, speaking engagements out of town,
mm-hmm.
like we just went to Chicago, I told KD, like, look, we come with me. Mm-hmm. We're going to go to Chicago. We're going to get it in. It's a day they paying for it. So let's go out there. Let's have fun on their dime. And we're going to come back the next day like everything is everything.
Right.
We'll go to like an arcade or something. Mm-hmm. Whatever. Everything. Take a walk anywhere.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes we'll just walk around the neighborhood.
And
just
that's what
it.
I like too.
And,
you don't always have to spend money just to like spend time together.
I have an objection.
Two.
Jay is out in the hallway not doing anything. We can make him be a whole nother guest. Random.
Okay.
All right, yeah. So we was also having a conversation last night about how men be lying on their dick.
Mm.
Right? So now I've never been the type of dude that lie on my dick.
What do you mean by lie?
Lying saying that I hit
like lying saying
so,
you hit something you didn't.
Oh.
So my question is, do women lie on their clit?
No.
I wouldn't.
That's stupid.
Why would you? I mean, that's
why would I put more miles in my pussy
that's
that don't
what I'm
belong
saying.
Me?
Right.
But are y'all answering from a older perspective versus
I don't think it's a woman in this world to be like, I fucked him
and
didn't.
Yeah, and didn't. Yeah, I don't see why men do it though. Why would men do it?
For the I think it's for the clout.
It is different for men. You're right.
Hey,
for men, the more bitches you fuck, the better.
The better, right.
But for women, the less miles you have, the better.
Right.
So I feel like if women lie, they downplay their
mm-hmm.
mileage.
Mm-hmm.
Right.
So I don't think no woman is
when
saying
it's 12,
they,
it's really like 3.
6. Or okay, well 3.
3 or 4. like I don't think, on one hand.
I don't think it's no woman. I don't think it's a woman alive that's saying like, oh, I fucked 3 people when in reality she fucked 2.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Where men, they probably only fuck 1 bitch and they're like, oh, I done fucked 12 bitches.
15.
Like, nigga, you a whole ass virgin.
100.
And when I give you this pussy, I'm going to know you a virgin.
Because you're not
so I wonder
to
what,
handle it, right?
Where did that come from, though? Who started that?
It came from like back in the day mm-hmm. when it's like a man can have 13 wives, mm-hmm. but a woman can only have 1 husband.
Right.
Like, it come from back in that day. Like, when mileage is frowned upon, but conquest are celebrated.
But that's crazy because like when you had more than 1 wife, you ain't lying and say, oh no, them 4 over there, them all my wives. No, it was like,
well, that's back in the day, but now, like, you gotta think, like, now men are supposed to be experienced and women are not supposed to be experienced. So if a man has had
inexperienced. I would lie down.
First
on my
of all,
dick.
I wish y'all could see her face.
First
right
of
now.
All, who the fuck inexperienced?
I'm just saying, I would lie down on my dick.
You should.
And exactly, that's what I'm saying.
Because you got miles on top of miles across the street for miles.
Dang.
Y'all should see her face.
No
right
Uber.
Now.
I'm just saying.
But what I'm saying is,
yes!
I feel like
because
when
my man been dropping off dick for years on top of years,
giving it. My thing is
that's real.
My thing is, I'm gonna lie down on it. Cause I feel like if you lie up on it, then
but you know what? Also,
be...
this, but it also goes back to the fact that men can cheat on their women and we are susceptible to it, and we can forgive it. You could fuck 30 bitches, and I'll be like, okay, baby, we can get through it. But let me fuck one nigga. Let me fuck one nigga that did some shit that you didn't do.
It's the end of the world. I let him
fuck me in my ass.
This the last day on earth.
Okay? Like, bitch, I never fucked you in your ass. And he fucked you in your ass.
That's it.
It's over with.
That's it.
So that's
he can't even look at you the same after that. That's it.
Period.
That's it.
And at the end of the day, women can overcome things. We can overcome kids. We can overcome infidelity. We can overcome all this shit. But let us suck one dick.
That's it.
That wasn't yours.
Yeah, that's it.
Bitch, it's over with.
That's true.
First of all, you every hoe in the book.
But why? I don't understand that, DTM. Please tell us.
Because you know what? I need to know. Well, fuck what he's talking about. That's what I'm saying.
I need to know because.
Because I feel like as women, we are the prize. And we are the conquest. So for them to fuck us, it is like a success. For us to fuck them is norm. So for somebody else to have had that same conquest, they can't handle it. They cannot handle it. And DCM, you tell me if I'm wrong.
Please tell me.
You're absolutely right. I mean, think about it. Men are way more liable to pay for pussy than it is for a woman to pay for dick.
That's true.
So
therefore, that lets you know.
Because it's accessible.
It's expensive. Like, it's something that you can put a price on versus us. You're like, what?
It don't mean anything.
And even if we say to ourselves, like, nah, y'all going to pay for this one way or another, still, you can't put a price on, like, look, I'm going to give it to you, but I'm going to need 70 for it.
I don't like the double
I'm gonna
standard.
Need to, you know what I'm saying?
But the double standard is so real.
I don't
though.
Like it though.
You gotta think about it. If a woman got like for me myself, I got 4 children.
Right.
If I was to be out in a dating scene right now, I could probably get another nigga. But my man right here, he's got the same 4 kids. A bitch gonna be like,
what?
You got 4 kids by the same bitch?
They gonna be like, how many baby mamas?
1.
What?
They straight
like, you
on
still
the floor.
Her.
They straight.
Sure.
Exactly.
For
and
sure.
That's going to be the attitude. The attitude going to be
sure.
Like, you still fucking her.
Definitely.
You still in love with her.
Definitely.
He could be like, no, she don't like me. They going to be like, nah, nigga, I'm straight.
Definitely.
But because the funny thing is I was listening to another podcast and they was like, if a nigga got 6 kids by 6 different bitches, they'll fuck with that nigga. Because nobody checking for you.
Yeah.
Because you got
different, yeah.
Your dick spread
you
around.
Wasn't there, right.
So everybody is expecting
exactly.
to you getting another bitch.
Right.
But if you got 6 kids by
the
same,
one,
bitch,
oh, you
they
love
straight.
Her. You in love.
Because
you
they
never,
like,
you
either you in love with her, she in love with you.
You never going to leave her alone.
This is a forever kind of thing.
Back and forth.
So that's that is where the double standard come in.
That's
because
how
if I got 6 kids by 6 different niggas, I'm a hoe.
Well, I told you, old girl came to me and that was her pickup line. She's like, I got 6 kids. What's up? I was like, nothing.
That's what
he told
me. He was like, a chick was checking for him at work. I got 6 kids, but, you know,
she
I got 6
she
kids.
She got that good.
I'm like,
I said, babe, what she was trying to tell you is like, niggas can't pull out.
She got that
he
good,
said,
well,
what I read from that is I'm straight.
Yeah.
Unless it was February, March time. You know,
he gonna
good.
Say, he gonna say
you know it.
He gonna say, baby, sex time is the bomb back in her crib.
Man, what?
I'm like, at the end of the day, that is real. That's a pickup line. Like,
I can't believe that's a pickup line.
I don't understand.
That's
a
pickup line.
I don't even know who would even
the pickup line
that.
For me.
I didn't even know women did pickup lines, number one. Like,
that's what I'm saying.
I'm not talking to you. I'm old school. I can be looking at you now. I'm gonna make eye contact. Like,
yes.
Hey.
I
stroll on through, but I'm not saying anything. You gonna
that's
come,
what I told
you gonna
him.
Come to me.
Not no more.
First of all, that's what I told him. He's like, hey,
that's crazy.
If we out and about and we see somebody that we feeling whatever, I said, first of all, I'm never approach. I don't give
never.
A fuck if it's a bitch or a nigga.
Never.
I'm never approaching them body.
Right.
Who?
But it seemed like.
Have you seen me?
But it seemed like
I'm a
in
cold
that situation.
But women come to me. So, I mean, I guess they do, though.
I think women supposed to go to women.
Do.
Like, when you talk to people
I
in the lifestyle. Women feel more comfortable when they're approached by a woman than they do when they're approached by a man. And the reason being is because think about when we go to the strip club and the girls, they just working.
Right.
They want to come dance for me.
But
they nervous because they like, I don't know. Let me see how
she. First of all, they know she crazy.
Exactly.
Most women are
but not even nowadays.
The dancers
like,
approach me.
They approach me too.
And they might approach you
be like,
to say,
dance?
Is it okay to dance? Right.
Or they be like, y'all want to dance?
Right.
Yeah, but I ain't approaching them. Yeah. And this
that's their job. So but right. they gotta approach you.
First of all, they rent depend on them approaching me. Right. So what the fuck I give a fuck about a bitch who rent don't depend on me approaching them. I'm never, let me tell you something. At the end of the day, if you see me and DTM out on the streets and you wanna fuck, you need to approach us.
Right.
Because I'm never approaching y'all.
Right.
I'm not gonna do it. I'm a cold piece. I'm a commodity.
I agree with that.
And I don't got a lot of miles on this pussy. So if you want to hit it, you don't have to approach us.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not doing it.
I don't know if I'm drunk enough. I might, though. I don't know.
First of all, if I'm drunk enough, I can't call it. At the end of the day.
Like, if I see somebody I'm attracted to, like, I might.
If I'm drunk enough, I might approach you, but you're not going to be our third.
Right.
You're going to be our fuck.
Yeah. I agree.
But if we're looking for a third, if we're looking for a unicorn, I am not going to approach the unicorn.
I don't want a unicorn. That's just too much. I can't. If we do it once, okay, that's it. I don't ever want to see you again, okay? I don't need my nigga to ever want to see you again. That's it.
But the benefits of a unicorn over just a normal threesome is, with the unicorn, you know you're safe. That's true. What I'm saying? Because you got to think about it.
First of all, DTM is way more.
That's true.
First of all, DTM is way more. What's the word I'm looking for?
Sexier.
I would just be worried that it's just gonna turn into other stuff.
DTM problem is he way more. He want way more from a unicorn than a unicorn want to give.
Mm.
Because first of all, DTM is a very demanding man.
Mm-hmm.
And then sometimes in a lifestyle that ain't what people looking for.
Mm. So this is my thing.
What is your thing?
This is my thing. All right. So if you are going to be a unicorn for us, there are a couple of rules that I'm looking at and my for myself.
Mm-hmm.
If you already have a man,
If the chick already have a man, how they gonna have a man and they gonna
Let's say they talking to somebody.
Okay,
let's use the quotation
like,
talking to somebody. It's the same thing these days
because
niggas would just claim it and be moved in or whatever. So let's say you talking to somebody, quote unquote.
Okay.
They can't see my finger, my air quote, but quote unquote talking to somebody, right?
Mm-hmm.
Whoever you are eyeing or talking to or thinking about or whatever, they have to be better than what you got here. Feel what I'm saying? So they got to be doing more than what you're going to get from us.
Okay.
You know what I mean?
Okay.
They got to be doing better in multiple areas than what you got what you got here because it's stupid.
Right.
That makes no sense for you to go mess with
you
a bum
downgrade.
When you are right.
Right, you can't downgrade.
So
right.
I'm not with that part for one.
Okay.
I'm also not with once you become with us, you can't add on people because the reason for you being a unicorn is because we're thinking about safety too.
Right.
I can't even if I put on a condom. Nobody's going to put on the condom and smash one and then take it off and then smash the wife and then put it back on. You're not going through that.
Yeah, that's
because if I'm not going to just keep myself safe. I got to keep her safe,
everybody,
too.
Right.
So I'm not going to be like, okay, I'm going to get your juices. I know you who are Randall. And then, Randall might have been with Michelle. And then Michelle might have been with whoever.
At the end of the day, when you have a threesome, if a man put on a condom, the only person he's protecting is himself.
Exactly. And that's why you got to look into that. Because
he's going to use the same condom to fuck me as he is going to fuck the next bitch.
There it is. And that's what I'm saying.
So at the end of the day, if she got chlamydia, he ain't going to get it.
But the other girl going to get it.
But I'm going to get it.
Right.
There it
is. So I get what you're saying. Like he really feel like a unicorn has to only be fucking us.
Right.
And I get it.
Now, if we lacking in some areas, if we like, we ain't never really kicking it with you. We only get to see you once a week or once a month, rather, or whatever the case may be. You missing something somewhere. Then, kick it with us and then let us know what it is and boom. But
so, okay, question.
Okay.
So, is it just sex? Like, so you just add a third person for sex? Or is it just like y'all texting and kicking
it? It's everything.
Just like a third person in the relationship.
It's like a third person in the relationship. Like, we would go on dates together. All three of us would go on dates.
Okay.
We would go, out of town. We would, everything. Come chill. We can watch some movies. We can go out to eat. We can get a cup of drink. We can get some of this reality juice in us. Everything.
How
you know what I'm saying? So it's a you will be.
So it's a huge difference between being a unicorn and being a threesome.
Right.
Yeah, definitely, for sure.
Unicorn is actually the third person in a relationship. So, like, if
so, who would get jealous though? Is what I'm wondering. Like, is it?
So,
like,
if you're a unicorn, it's technically not supposed to be any jealousy.
I feel like I would be too jealous.
But so, if you're a unicorn, it's supposed to be if you feel like you want to hang out with just him, you're supposed to be like, "Hey, I just want to hang out with him," and it's supposed to be okay. Mm-hmm. Or if you want to hang out with just the female, it's supposed to be okay. Like, those are things that when you are in a lifestyle and you are and you have accepted a unicorn, those are things that are supposed to be accepted upon. That's why I said, like, with the girl that was like the true relationship, if you accept her as a unicorn, that's then you're supposed to let her come live with you.
That's what it is.
Are she referring to the last week podcast?
Last week podcast, the, when baby girl
KD.
Said, "Hey, you know, like, this is my this is my third person, and this is the thing. At the end of the day, if that's the thing, then it's supposed to be, hey, we are all three in a relationship."
Right.
And she's supposed to be able to come live with you.
Right.
Because that's the same thing if I'm dating a person and something happens where I lose my house, I'm supposed to be able to call him like, "Hey, hey, boo, I lost my house."
Right.
"Okay, well, you can come live here until you get your..." That's the same thing.
Yeah.
It's a huge difference in being a lifestyle and experiment in threesomes. It's a huge difference.
So would you have a threesome first, or would you go straight to, like, the unicorn relationship?
It depends on what you're trying to do. So my thing is, if you're looking for a unicorn, right, then everything is supposed to be on the floor before you fuck.
Right.
So if you're looking for a threesome is like, we all about to fuck, and tomorrow we don't know each other.
That's it.
But if you're looking for a unicorn, it's supposed to be... We are together. We both his woman. And whatever happens from there happens from there.
So do you think people have threesomes first, or do you think people just jump straight to unicorns?
I think it's
unicorns?
Both. I think it's both.
No, I don't think it's both. I think either you want a threesome or you want a unicorn.
But I'm like, because it's not interchangeable.
It's not interchangeable.
Okay.
Because if you're looking for a unicorn, you're not looking for a threesome. But if you're looking for a threesome, then you're not looking for a unicorn.
I guess that is a whole relationship, though.
Yeah, if you're looking for a threesome, then you like,
just
bitch, we never want to see you again.
And that's how I am. Because I'm like, look.
Because you looking for a threesome.
Yeah, so I would do the threesome. Period. But the unicorn, I'm like, bitch, no, I don't like you like that. The fuck?
And that's the thing. So at the end of the day, you're looking for a threesome. You're not looking for a unicorn because you're like, bitch, don't ever hit my nigga up again.
Yeah, I don't. Yeah.
But when you're looking for a unicorn, you are in a acceptance that this our nigga.
Right.
Whatever comes from here comes from
it
here.
It comes. Right.
So you're not gonna find a unicorn in a strip club.
No, negative. They
so
trying
where
to get
would
paid.
You find it? Where would you find it right there?
That is the question of the motherfucking day.
Maybe
because we went to a whole motherfucking lifestyle party and bitch, we saw a whole motherfucking person that we knew.
Oh my god! And it was so.
Maybe you will find them at the lifestyle party, though.
You're supposed to find them at the lifestyle party.
You will, but I also think that it's kind of like an everyday thing. You know how you go, like, you might go to the mall, or you might go to wherever. You might see somebody where you having dinner with your man or whatever, and y'all just start kicking it. You're like, oh, I kind of like this vibe.
But how do you approach that though? Like, I mean, especially.
How do you approach it, babe?
I think it's kind of
like that. Like,
I just think it's casual. I think you know, you just kind of see
mall,
where they at,
like,
with
hey,
it.
You
nah,
unicorn,
you ain't gonna
you,
just. I don't think you gonna walk
unicorn.
Up to him like, "Hey, what's up? We want to holler at you," type thing. It's more like, "Let me see where your mind at. What's up? Let me talk to you for a minute. You good?
How do you approach it though? You just say,
probably
hey,
the same way, like a regular normal conversation. What you doing? You out here? You shopping? Oh, okay. What you about to get into?
I get it.
Yeah? No? Okay. What you like to do, though? What's you know what I mean? Just every small
time. But I'm so mean.
Time.
I don't talk to people.
That's
nowhere.
My problem.
Like, I don't want to talk to you anywhere. No. Like, why are you stopping me? Hi.
But, and that's how you can almost gauge who can get in.
Right.
By the person who can break down that barrier and actually get KD for sure to start talking back.
Mm-hmm.
Or... for you to start talking back to him, you're like, oh, okay, that might be.
Because I'm gonna say hi. That might be a strong.
So the problem with me is the people that can break down my barriers don't want to be our unicorns.
I mean, and to me, I feel like the right one will come when they're ready. or when
it'll
we get
to, when
you know
it's
what I'm saying?
To happen.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So
that's my, adequate.
Everything happens for a reason.
Because at the end of the day, I am not the nicest person.
Definitely not.
And I am with I but I stand firm on that though. Because this is my thing though. Like, I love hard, but I hate even harder. Mm-hmm. So, like, you come through on my love and that's where it can be. But I'm not a friendly bitch. Oh, this my friend. Like,
I'm
no,
that,
bitch.
Right. You don't have
not.
Friends. Right. What?
Oh, here
your
this
friend who?
Motherfucker.
Oh, there it is.
I'm the same way. Because she doesn't have friends. I don't understand.
That's what I'm saying, though. Friend. So I feel like if ever we were to meet our unicorn, they would have to be a strong motherfucker, for one. Mm-hmm. And for two, I cannot. Like, it's a couple motherfuckers that I'd be like, oh, that could be my unicorn.
I gotta like them first of all.
I got about two motherfuckers that I could that I would accept being my unicorn.
Listen, I threw a name out there one day, KiKI. Right?
Oh, here you go.
I was like,
hey, that bullshit.
I said, hey, what you think about so and so? Right? Mm. She texted me back like, no, I don't like her as a person. I was like, dang. I was like, oh,
why he on some bullshit though? Okay. I did do that though.
I can see it though.
I was like, oh, okay.
I was like, why the fuck would you even ask me about that person?
That's so true.
Man, I mean,
if that person
you
was
known, like, but, if it was that.
No, they didn't even really have I don't even remember seeing them
she
have any
like
kind of conversation.
Like that, though, so you can't just right. throw random names.
But no, see, at the end of the day, this is what he got to accept at the end of the day. I am a motherfucking private investigator. And sometimes you might feel some type of way about a bitch that I already have some information
right,
about. You know what I'm saying? Like, you don't think I know shit, but in there
I know
everything.
Well, I know you know everything.
She definitely a private investigator.
You ain't thought I know everything when you threw that name out there, because I had already hacked some shit.
Listen, we've been together 20 years. Dude. So if you think that I don't think you know everything.
Then why would you say her name, though?
Well, why would I not?
Because I had already hacked some shit.
So she already
knew everything, but ain't nothing happened.
That name.
You sure?
I'm 100% sure.
You're not 100% sure.
Oh my god.
We just talked about the lying part. I'm not lying on my dick.
No, I don't think you fucked her, but the conversation that y'all had was inappropriate.
To you, it may not have been, but to her, it was.
No, it was.
And that's why.
No,
I never
I'm telling
nothing.
You,
just,
it was.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
All right. Well, you got it. It was inappropriate, you guys.
You don't want to play with the wife, you okay?
Because I'm telling you that it wasn't appropriate. Yeah. That's how I felt.
If it was inappropriate to her, it was inappropriate.
That's why we got to start recording, video recording.
First of all, if they saw the motherfucking video, they'd be like, oh my God, look at her face.
Oh, yeah, for sure.
Y'all, I'm a face magnet.
And when she get mad or when she get adamant about something, only one side of her face turn red.
BFF, say it.
I didn't say it from like I knew it. I just
no, you do know it. Don't lie.
I know he was about to
first
say.
First of all, let me tell y'all. One time, my BFF canceled Mother's Day.
That's true. That's true. I remember that.
Shit happened.
And it came through. It came through
like,
in a text. Like nope.
That nigga's
Mother's
like
canceled.
Mother's Day canceled. I was like, bitch, what the fuck you mean Mother's Day canceled?
That was a rough.
We got whole ass kids over here.
I had two bags of chocolate on my shoulder. Trying to figure out, like, wait a minute.
We got motherfucking hamburgers with the onions and shit. Next week is Mother's Day, y'all. And Mother's Day is not canceled house.
I mean, that was so long ago, though.
It don't matter. Some shit
that
you never
like
forget.
6 years ago.
It was not six
five
years
ago.
It was 5 years ago.
It's a long time ago.
Yeah.
That was a rough day, okay?
It was a rough day.
It was a rough day.
Hallelujah.
Man.
We've moved on since then.
DCM, what questions you got for us?
All right, so let me see. We got one more.
We've been wilding this whole episode. This episode gonna be called Wild Conversation.
Yeah, because it's a little bit everywhere, but it's good. Though.
It is everywhere, but it's hot though.
I forgot we were doing a podcast.
Actually. We did forget it was been
like a regular conversation.
For us. This is like FYI. This is how we talk at home
every day.
Do y'all think it's perks to being a side person, like a side chick or a side dude?
Perks?
Yeah.
Perks?
Yeah, like, so if you were a side, do you think
So what? I listen to a podcast called Bully and the Beast. If y'all ain't listened to it, y'all should listen to it because it's hot.
It's number two right up under us.
It's number two right up under us, but it's called Bully and the Beast. It's with L'Oreal and Wax.
Not Wax, Tex, and Dre.
No,
Wax.
I forgot the nigga name, but his name just like Wax, whatever, right? So I listen to their podcast. So on their podcast, Wax said that he preferred to be number five.
Ooh, we trying to get down on the bottom of the list.
Wait, first of all, a bitch busting that pussy up for several niggas. But the reason why.
Attachment, though.
The reason why is he said because number five has more honesty than number one through four.
You can tell him anything.
Is he single?
He will never admit or deny that he's single on the thing.
Because that's a dang.
But this a thing, though. At the end of the day, I kind of feel what he's saying. Mm-hmm. Because at the main chick, because I have experience being the main chick for the past 20 years, we never know shit.
Five is all the way down there.
But as number one, you never know shit.
You got five, though.
But a motherfucker could be fucking 12 bitches.
I don't want to be five.
But this is the thing, though. As number one, you never know shit.
Five is bad.
As number two, you know some shit. Right. As number three, you probably know a little more.
Yeah.
As number four, you probably know a little more. And as number five, you probably know a little more.
That's a lot.
It is a lot.
I don't want nobody about with it. That many.
But you know what he said? He says numbers as number five, you probably never fucking a bitch. You probably are just her shoulder to cry on. But as number one, you never know shit.
If you smashing that number five, you got to worry about at least 20 people.
That's what I'm like. That's a lot.
Yeah, but as number one, what do you know?
As
number one, what do you know?
They're not going to tell you nothing.
You don't know shit as number one.
That's true.
As number one, you the only one. I love you. Blah, 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 blah. As number two, you at least know I'm fucking this bitch. Right. And you.
Right.
So I feel like as a side person, mm-hmm. you know way more than as a quote unquote main person though.
That's true.
But I feel like
I can't be a side chick because I require too much attention. Mm-hmm. And when I wanna fuck, I wanna fuck. And I don't care if you're like, oh, I gotta see my bitch. I don't give a fuck about that bitch. I wanna fuck. And if you don't fuck me, I'm going to fuck somewhere.
She's some thug. Where did this thug come from? She's some thug.
I've been gutter, though. At the end of the day, I want to fuck.
Right, you see the face.
I want to fuck.
Got my dick getting hard over here.
And at the end of the day.
I've been gutter.
She's serious.
At the end of the day.
She's serious.
At the end of the day.
Day. Talk to him. Talk to him.
I'm not going
to
fuck myself.
Talk to him.
So, if you're not available to fuck me, I'm going to fuck someone else.
I know that's right.
But I like watching you when you do that, too.
Well, it's whatever.
That's true.
That's why you need to make that dick more available.
I'm saying I like watching you when you, you know what.
Because if that dick not available, then get in where you fit in, bro.
Number five, number six, number seven.
Get in where you fit in, bro.
Then they going to have a problem when you go somewhere else. Because they're going to be like, hold on now.
Get in where you fit in.
Hold on now.
Because I'm trying to get this dust knocked off.
Ooh.
So if you're not the knocker offer,
it's going to be somebody else.
You best believe.
I'm not mad.
Because dick ain't the only commodity in this world. Because this type pussy can sell records.
She says sell records.
Records.
Or drinks.
Or let's make sure it sell them drink though, okay?
What drinks? What drinks is it?
Oh, that reality. That reality.
Reality juice.
So let's just talk about this reality juice for a minute. What kind of flavors we got with this reality juice?
Oh.
Maybe we should make this part of a...
When I say I'm so buzzed off the one today, okay?
So this show
and
is actually...
And it has my body all warm.
Mm. Oh, kill them.
Yes.
So for reality let's say juice.
We got some sponsors today. The sponsors for the day of the reality juice.
So for reality juice, we got the pink pussy, the threesome, the orgasm, and the menage.
That's what we got so far. They will be going up for sale shortly. We just got to get everything together. But it will be going up for sale. I'm telling y'all, these right here are next level. These are next level right here. So y'all definitely want to go into that.
Excellent.
So, KiKI. Man, I appreciate you coming through and
I love being
now being a part of the show.
Love it.
You know what I'm saying? You back with us? Well, I don't know. Are we gonna do it? We gonna be able to do it next week? I know next week is Mother's Day.
Oh, it is Mother's Day.
So I gotta figure out what we.
We gotta see what our schedule is first.
Yeah. So we definitely gonna get y'all what y'all need though. You know what I'm saying? We make sure you're not gonna miss a week. We'll figure it out somehow, some way. I definitely want to give you guys, make sure y'all listen to us on iHeartRadio, please.
We need them numbers to go up on iHeartRadio. We are, like I said, we're number one on almost every social site that we are on. So I need y'all to help us stay there by listening to us on iHeartRadio, liking it, commenting, sharing. Everybody in your circle and everybody in your circle need to know that, you know, relationship reality is what it is. And we're going to do what we came to do. All right. So, iHeartRadio, Podbean, Ask KD. Use the hashtag Ask KD. We also have an email. I'm going to let KD give you that email in a minute. I think it's like askayd@gmail.com. I think I got it right.
Don't think. Just wait for KD.
I think I got that part right.
In 1 second.
So, let's see. Let's jump. I'm going to give you guys the motivational tip for this week, and then we're going to come back for, you know, the email address and all that good stuff. All right. So, KiKI, you heard of secondhand smoke, right?
I have.
All right, so secondhand smoke, they say it can be more dangerous than firsthand smoke.
Exactly.
But I'm going to give you a different spin on this. Motivational tip for this week is stay away from secondhand negativity.
Oh, amen. My goodness.
All right, so secondhand negativity.
Say it again for the bitches in the back.
Stay away from secondhand negativity.
Oh, all right? My goodness.
So you can be in such a great mood, but if you surround yourself with somebody who's negative, that will rub off on you, and you will be upset about something have no idea why.
Yes.
And when you all it takes is a little bit. Once you start being negative, and once you start being down, it's gonna spiral down on you. You're gonna be mad about everything for no reason, and it's crazy. Like, I got some people at work that just I ain't gonna say no names, but my man will come in negative. Hey, what time are we going to leave? I don't know. Oh, my God.
We just got here.
Yeah, you walk in ready to go.
I do that at work, though. Man. I wouldn't say that's negative. I'd just be trying to speak my day.
But it's like,
I'm still going to do my job.
But it'd be like, we ain't never going to leave.
Oh, yeah, no.
Or it'd be, okay. You know what I'm saying? Like, don't come in ready to leave. And don't come in waiting on Friday. Like, you know.
That's true.
Just live your life, man. It's short. But it can be long and it can be luxurious if you make it that way. Just stay away from secondhand negativity.
That's true.
Because most of the time, our negativity comes from somewhere else. It's never really something that we came on ourselves. It's something that came from somewhere else. All right. So stay away from that. Stay positive. Stay on that grind. Stay being who you are to be. I heard something from Maya Angelou that said, be the best you can be until you get better. Mm-hmm. And then when you get better, Do better.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes, KD,
yes.
Let them know where they can find us at. Give them their email address. I tried to get it, but I don't know if I had it right. Let's see if I had it.
I think it was.
Ask.kayd@gmail.com.
Yeah, that's your Ask KD. if you want to follow us on social media, you can follow us on Instagram at Relationship Reality Podcast. You can follow me on Keisha.KD. You can follow him at Deontay_the_motivator. You can follow us on Facebook at Relationship Reality Podcast, the podcast. My apologies.
Secret group.
We are going to have a future Instagram at Reality Juice.
That is going
to be the way
that.
You can be able to get our reality cocktails that we have here on the podcast.
Yes.
You can follow us on Reality Juice. We'll have the emails that you can follow us on that on next week's podcast. And that's about it, because KiKI will not allow you to follow her. But you know what? We're going to have I just make an executive decision.
Uh-oh.
I love when she does.
On next week, we are going to have a Instagram that you're going to follow KiKI on that is going to be mastered and followed by me.
That should be interesting.
I am going to be the executive of that their podcast. But for those of you all that want to follow her and ask her questions, I'm going to have a way that you can do that.
That's so nice of her. I love her
by
so
her
much.
Being our third host. You know what I'm saying? Two girls, one man. Wow, you know, wow. Y'all like two women, one cup. We got two girls, one man.
Yes.
And I'm going to have a way that you can follow her. And I'm going to be the master of that. So
that
some some messages she will see and some messages she will not.
I will see none of them.
No, some you will see.
Some I will see.
But that will be based on that will be based on how I feel.
I will see none of them. Some I will see, though. Some I will.
So when y'all be a little loose, that'd probably be in a trash compartment. You know, so yeah, so we gonna be able to get that together. But yeah, that's how y'all can follow us. You can listen to this here podcast on.
Tell them again.
iHeartRadio.
Tell them again.
Woo!
Oh, there you go, there you go, there you go.
Ding, ding, ding. You gonna listen to us on iHeartRadio at Relationship Reality.
Everybody has iHeartRadio.
They should.
Please listen.
And if they don't, they should again.
Listen. We got Google Play, right? We on the Google Play.
So we are on Google Play Music. Okay. We are on Spotify. We are on Apple Podcasts. We are on Podbean. Like, you know what? If you look and listen to us, we are there. You know, it's about what you want to do.
Please listen.
So we really are available to listen to all major platforms. And if you have a podcast preference that we are not on, shoot us a DM, baby. We'll get on there. You know, that's all you got to do is communicate, and we'll be on there wherever you want to be.
Key to life.
We everywhere, wherever you listening.
Wait, that's where we at. Number one podcast in the world.
Number one podcast.
So we trying to make it to the Oprah show. We're trying to see if we can get a show on OWNS or something. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, okay.
You know what I'm saying? You get a show.
Everybody gets a show.
You know what I'm saying?
Wildin',
though. Hey, let's do it, man. So we would definitely, man, listen, man, y'all have an amazing week, man. We will see you guys next week.
Yes.
Peace.
Two of them.
Deuces.